Hang on there, John. Ooh, gold fields.
Where is that?
Peter! Could you do me the favour, Peter, of taking... Hello, Paul. This is Utopia. This definitely beats Detroit.
We shut him off. Go this way.
Peter. We need Detroit.
Another burning wood.
That's human.
Burning human. It's motel hell.
Oh, hell's gate.
Where?
Can you smell it? You go through a tongue and it turns into like Freddy's place.
Freddy's bum hole.
Yeah,
sordid graphic imagination.
First train moving, big red train. Oh yeah, look. Now look at that, four fucking trains on it, man. No, three. Is it three or four? Four trains. Wow.
We've arrived at Hell's Gate.
Yeah, here we are. There's the gate.
Looks like...
Healthcare buses allowed.
What?
A lifetime.
Let's go up on the thing,
shall
we?
Yeah. 10 minutes ahead. He's living in fucking Wales. And he's got an antique shop somewhere like fucking Bangor or somewhere. They've all just gone into nothingness.
Yeah. Tell you who else they had on one of those was the girl on the BBC Two Tesco. Again, this?
Hell's Gate.
Why is it called Hell's Gate?
Because it's a gateway to hell.
It's a gateway
to
hell.
It's a thing you can go on, it's like a chair ride or something.
Yeah, that we're going to go on.
It's the gateway to Krell, did you say?
Yeah.
Krell's Gate.
Hell's Gate air tram.
Oh, do not roll rock.
What? This thing in
fleck?
Where?
Do not roll rock.
When to come up and then I'll play it.
Yeah, it'll pass us.
Camera the ready, Johnny.
For those of you that haven't been on here before, we're going to go through a vertical descent of 500 feet. We're going to cross over the Canadian National Railroad, the Fraser River, and the International Fishways. On the far banks, the Canadian Pacific Railroad. It was constructed in 1880. Crossing over the Canadian National, it was constructed in 1912. During construction, workers were blasting a tunnel through the mountain just below us. The blast caused a natural fault in the rock that you see to your right-hand side. Tons of rock and debris went into the Fraser River, and what it did was alter the current, so only 10% of the salmon could go through to spawn. So in 1944, the United States and Canada built the International Fishways, and those are the cement structures you see on either side of the river. But they are a vertical baffles that slow the water from 20 miles an hour to 2. Now approximately 90% of the salmon go through here to spawn. This is the narrowest part of the Fraser River. It is 110 feet wide and today is approximately 120 feet deep. Sorry.
See the water between 120 feet?
Yes, right below us. High water is about 170 feet. You see the water line on the bank over there?
Oh, yeah.
In 19- 1948, the water was as high as to take out this bridge to your left.
That's right.
It's never been that high since. Coming into our complex, Salmon House Restaurant. We are on a limited menu, as we just opened, but there's sandwiches and our famous salmon chowder. Bullpanner gift shop has BC jade and other handicrafts. Also in there is a fisheries display. Fudge factory, we make our own fudge. Unfortunately, Trapper John's isn't open. The bridge to your left is open. You can go out there and take pictures if you like. Spend as much time down here as you want. When you're ready to come back, wait behind the fence and I'll come down and pick you up.
Through Harrison Hot Springs, which is where we... one of it is, we should go on the freeway one, shouldn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, which is one.
Yeah, I want to come in on one.
Yeah, okay.
Get us to grab a small marine mammal, or just to give themselves a belly or back scratch. They really seem to enjoy it. In fact, between the shows, they'll do it quite often. If you're wondering whether these whales can hear you or not, they certainly can, so if you want to give them some encouragement now and then, just go right ahead. I'm sure they'd appreciate it. come up on the beach.
There he goes.
And he's got lots of teeth, about 40 to 50 cone-shaped teeth and a big mustard tongue. Those teeth are very sharp, but if you watch throughout the show, you'll notice they don't chew their food. Everything that they swallow goes down whole or in very large chunks. We believe they use these teeth mainly for tearing and grasping at their prey. And on the back, that's known as the dorsal fin. If you're ever looking for killer whales in the wild, watch out for this dorsal fin. It's the first thing that you'll see. It's about, can be about 6 feet in height. You see the Inderjit can move it quite easily. This is because there's no bone or muscle at all in this dorsal fin. It's mainly a cartilage-type material, much like our own nose and ears.
Can we walk there?
That's going to come up and over that beach. There he goes.
Where we do the other home videos. This is where the band entertain young ladies.
We are standing in front of the new bus. This is the first time the new bus has been on film.
I think so.
The camera.
There we go.
stories in the process, folks.
Goodness will come down.
Danny Bourne, director. Lift, the movie. A new major motion picture starring John the DT, the deteriorated D. Teodoro.
Love.
Danny Vaughan, cameraman, director, T-boy.
Daniel One-Eye,
best boy.
Sugar Ray Vaughan.
Gaffer Grip.
Gaffer, best boy. Grip. Cheap grip. Not so hard grip.
Wish he had a better grip.
Best grip.
Get your hands off me.
Grip. No bags yet.
The lead journey safely executed. Bags still in the rooms. Shutting the door in Sugar Ray Vaughan's face.